WFLA TV, 8 on your side. This is News Channel 8 at 11, Weekend Edition.
Boy, last weekend was a nightmare, but this Sunday is a dream come true for Bucs fans as the Pewter pound the pitiful Bears and power on to the playoffs. Good evening, I'm Mike Walter. Diane Roberts has the night off. How sweet it is. The Bucs bashed the Bears this afternoon in front of a full house of rowdy Buccaneer fans. You can see from our Eagle 8 helicopter there were not many empty seats this afternoon, and there probably won't be any for the upcoming playoff game. Diehard fans are wasting no time. Folks in line are just continuing their tailgate party from this afternoon and hoping for playoff tickets. We'll have complete ticket information in just a minute or so. First, though, let's talk about today's big Buccaneer win. John McQuiston is here to talk about that. John?
Yes, indeed. Doesn't get much better than that for the Bucs. The players all said this was the biggest day in their careers. The Bucs had already qualified for the playoffs, but they insisted that it was important to win this game and to look good doing it to build their confidence going into the playoffs, and that they appeared to do. Trent Dilfer threw a touchdown pass, but also on this play, there isn't anybody to throw to, so he runs, bad ankle and all, 7 yards for the touchdown, punctuates it with that emphatic spike as the Buccaneers punctuate, that is, their season with an emphatic victory. In other words, they played better than I just talked. But anyway, they finished the season 10-6. We will have a whole bunch on the Buccaneers game today and their matchup with the Detroit Lions next Sunday coming up in Sunday Sports Extra.
Hard to talk. We're pretty excited about this.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks a lot, John. Well, today's win has the fans in a frenzy, obviously. This is the first time since 1979 the Bucs have secured the home field advantage in the postseason. News Channel 8's Jennifer Speed is live right now at Houlihan Stadium, where fans are already camped out to ensure a seat at Saturday's big show. Jennifer?
That's right, Mike. In fact, this is a day fans like these have dreamed of for years, and as they sleep here tonight to guarantee a ticket tomorrow, I am sure there will be visions of a Bucs playoff win dancing in their heads.
Did somebody say playoffs? Well, the Buccaneers sure got the message and came more than ready to battle the Bears for home field advantage.
We did it! We did it!
Fans were crazed by the powerful Pewter performance and are already predicting a smooth cruise through the playoffs.
Hopefully we will, pull it off this year.
Oh, we will pull it off.
Pull it off.
No problem. We will overcome. We are going to win. We are going all the way this year.
World Series superstar Gary Sheffield was at the game. He knows what it's like to hit the bigs and expects the hometown crowd to provide an edge for Tampa Bay's team.
I think it's very important, you know, when you have the crowd behind us, you know, being in the World Series, we know what that's about. And, you know, when you have that crowd behind you, it just gives you that extra energy and it pulls people together.
It's already pulling people together, from frenzied fans and Bucs owner Malcolm Glazer to gridiron standouts Mike Allstott and Warwick Dunn.
We knew a day like this would come.
Diehards just hope the sun doesn't set till the Super Bowl.
Now, here is that coveted ticket information. Playoff tickets go on sale tomorrow at 10, even though these people are camped out here right now. They're just waiting. Now, they are available here at Houlihan Stadium and at any Ticketmaster location, but beware, you have to actually go to the Ticketmaster location to get the tickets. They are not going to sell them over the phone because they don't want any kind of brokers buying them from out of town in bulk. They want to make sure that this is, in fact, a hometown crowd that roots the Bucs on. Mike?
And, Jen, we know that they're pretty excited. How long have those folks been waiting in line out there?
Well, you know what? I've talked to some people who say they've been here since last night. One woman even said she was here since 7 this morning, which, of course, is long before today's game even started.
All right. Thanks, Jennifer. Obviously excited behind you. Thanks so much for that.
Yeah, definitely so. Yeah.
Well, with all the excitement, chances are you can't get enough of the Bucs. As you get ready for the big playoff game, News Channel 8 Sports is here to help you. We're working on a special on this dream season. It's called Pewter Power to the Playoffs. It will air next Saturday night at 7:30 on the eve of the Bucs showdown with the Lions. The warnings are out. The river is rising and shelters are open. The Withlacoochee River will crest tomorrow in Pasco and Hernando counties near Ridge Manor and Trilby. We're looking at an eagle-eye view of the river waters already rising earlier today. For the people who live along the river, there is nothing they can do tonight but wait. You can't help but think this looks so tranquil.
Yeah, now I gotta take us through here to get there, though.
That's until you talk to Steve Kramer. He lives along the banks of the river, banks that are brimming.
From what I've heard, this is about as bad as it gets or has gotten.
He gave us a tour. It's a bumpy ride.
Whoa! Watch the branch.
Right now he can laugh as the dogs come out and frolic in the water. Kramer says they have good reason to be confused.
Doghouse underwater.
While the doghouse is underwater, Kramer's is not, at least not yet. But the doghouse is not alone. Chain-link fences barely peer out above the water. They say letter carriers will travel through sleet, rain, and snow. But I don't think the Davies are worried about picking up their mail if the water continues to climb.
That's got to be some hard paddling.
Along the way, we run into some people who don't have a boat. It's a couple fighting the water and depression as they trudge closer to their home. Like many here, they bought it because they wanted to be on the water, not in it.
Just bought the property for building the house on in the future, but it don't look very good at this point. Looks like it's going to turn into a bad investment and a lot.
We continue on, and when we return, we run into the couple on the bike again.
Well, it looks like ours is up in the higher end anyhow, for what it's worth.
It's worth something now. The question is, will it still be on the higher end when the river crests on Monday?
Of course, we don't have that answer, but we do know where the Red Cross shelter is, though. It's located at Eastside Elementary School on Roper Road. A Bay Area family is recovering from the scare of their lives last night. Home invasion. It happened in Tampa at Arlington near Woodlawn. Police say three men barged their way into the home on Arlington Street around 9 o'clock last night. Brett Rhodes, some children, and their grandmother were wrapping Christmas presents when the masked men came to the door demanding drugs and money. Rhodes denied having either and was pistol whipped by the men. One day after the beating, he has mixed emotions.
Everything is fine so far, just a little shook up. A little frustrated, a little mad, a little angry. But apparently, I just think everything's all right and the kids and nobody get hurt.
A bullet grazed Rhodes' face and head, but he is doing fine tonight. A horrible story out of San Francisco this evening. A two-year-old toddler fell to her death from the Golden Gate Bridge earlier this evening. She was walking with her four-year-old brother when she slipped through a 9.5-inch crack in the bridge. Officials say she fell about 180 feet to the ground below. The parents requested the baby's identity and their hometown not be released. Elsewhere around America tonight, President Clinton and the First Family are headed to Bosnia. Clinton will meet with government leaders and tell U.S. peacekeeping troops he's decided to keep them there indefinitely. It's the 9th anniversary of the bombing of Pan Am Flight 103. Relatives of the victims want the government to allow a trial of the suspects in a neutral country. Two Libyans are accused, but their government has refused to extradite them. And Americans are serious about their holiday shopping. Stores and malls were jammed, and retailers now say this was the busiest shopping weekend of the season. It's the season for giving, and Metropolitan Ministries needs you to give. 3,700 families need help this holiday season. Workers say they still need a lot of toys for toddlers, along with activities and games for preteen boys and girls. As always, food is also a necessity. Donations can be dropped off on North Florida Avenue in Tampa or call area code 813-209-1000. Well, when you go grocery shopping, don't forget about the Food for Families food drive. They need non-perishable foods such as canned vegetables and fruits. Just drop them in the big barrels. You can find the barrels at Bay Area Publix, Cash and Carry, and Winn-Dixie stores. Food for Families runs through December 28th. If you wish you had more cash to buy presents, then listen up. Nobody won the $30 million lotto jackpot, so it rolls over to a whopping $55 million. This is the first triple rollover in nearly 3 years. No one has won the lotto jackpot since Thanksgiving weekend, when a $26 million ticket was purchased in Lantana. Those of you winning smaller amounts may want to check these numbers again. 6, 16, 30, 32, 40, and 45. Your cash three numbers are 0, 1, and 4. And play 4, 7, 1, 0, and 1. Away in a Manger. It's a familiar Christmas carol known to many, and tonight it came alive. Come with us to this live manger scene. A single Sunday school class actually started this tradition 30 years ago. The live reenactment continues at the First Presbyterian Church in St. Petersburg, along with Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. There are lambs, goats, and mules. You can see it for yourself tomorrow and Tuesday from 7 until 9 p.m. Jack Frost sure isn't nipping at Florida noses tonight. Coming up, will the Christmas heat melt our holiday spirits. Craig Setzer will have your holiday weather report. That's next. And later, find out about one man who picked up the tab for more than 1,800 people at a very special shopping spree.
We realize that not everyone has to wear a suit to the office these days. But chances are, you still have to wear shoes.
The Men's Warehouse.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
There's excitement in the air.
It's crunch time.
We've got two boys, two girls. You know, it's from one end of the store to the other.
They wait to the last minute. They don't know what to buy.
I will fill this cart in about 20 minutes.
We're there to help them, though.
Oh, the adrenaline starts pumping, and you choo, up and down every aisle.
The people at Walmart seem to recognize that frenzied look on your face.
I forgot this person. I forgot that person.
So they're real receptive and helpful.
We got plenty of stuff left.
Walmart has great prices right up till the last minute.
I'm an expert last-minute shopper. Please come to me.
When you're getting ready for the holidays, don't forget Winn-Dixie. Delight your guests with a delicious WD Super Trim Shank Portion Smoked Ham, just 99 cents a pound. 2-liter Coke favorites are 64 cents when you buy two with a coupon from our mailer. And WD Select Lean Whole Boneless Pork Loin is $1.99 a pound. Shop Winn-Dixie for the holidays.
How would you play if it were the last football game of the season? How would you play if you were playing in the Outback Bowl? It's back and it's sizzling. Georgia versus Wisconsin. See Georgia's superstar Hines Ward and rushing phenom Robert Edwards tangle with Wisconsin's touchdown king, Ron the Great Dane Dane. Call 287-8844 for tickets now and be there when they play like they'll never play again.
For Christmas and all year round, nothing escapes the power of the dirt devil.
Residents in New Mexico are living out a true Midwest Christmas. Only problem is they're not in the Midwest. A winter storm dumped several inches of snow in Albuquerque yesterday. And, of course, you can do what I always do in a case like this. Blame it on El Nino.
That's right.
El Nino's responsible for everything.
That's right. That's right. El Nino worked against the Bears today, didn't it?
El Nino killed the Bears today.
Well, El Nino may be responsible for our wet weather. That's at least the trends are that way. Is also probably responsible for this funnel cloud. It did touch down briefly as a waterspout and then a tornado. This near Huntington Beach, California. There was some damage to some boats, some docks, even one roof of a home. It's another powerful storm system coming into Southern California. And as this storm moves on towards the east, it will catch up with our weather. It looks like probably on Wednesday. For the rest of the night, though, and in through the morning hours, we're expecting mostly cloudy skies to continue. Scattered showers around, not a widespread rainfall, but scattered showers around. You may want to take an umbrella tomorrow as you head to work. 64 degrees, your 8 a.m. temperature by noon, 74 degrees, mostly cloudy skies, much like we saw today. Temperatures right now in the 60s, mid-60s to the north. 69 in Tampa, 68 in Clearwater, also in Newport Richey. Also 68 coming in from Lakeland and Winter Haven, 72 in Sarasota, and 70 in Punta Gorda. Temperatures will be slow to fall tonight as the dew point temperatures, the way we measure moisture, is relatively high, so humidities are also high. Temperatures across the southern half of the state right now in the 70s, low to mid, and in some places upper 70s, pretty mild evening. 60s to the north, once again, though, moisture levels rather high now in the atmosphere, especially lower portions of the atmosphere, so temperatures will be very slow to fall overnight tonight. Here's the way things look over the Gulf of Mexico. We saw this high cloudiness streaming out of the Pacific today across Mexico and then across the Gulf over Florida. It has started to push on to the southeast, but this band right here, it's part of a cold front which is pushing towards us. We're looking for some showers and thunderstorms to pop up ahead of that front. You can already see some activity starting to go up here to our west. That's expected to increase overnight and gradually drift eastward, so thus we'll see the showers, maybe even a thunderstorm during the day for tomorrow. So here's the forecast then for tonight. Mostly cloudy skies, 64 our forecast low. Chance for some scattered showers around tonight. And then for tomorrow, mostly cloudy skies continuing and a chance for showers off and on throughout the day. About a 40 to 50% chance. High temperature near 78 degrees. For marine and boating interests, southeast to southerly winds, 10 to 15 knots, seas 2 to 4 feet. Visibility 3 to 7 miles, Gulf temperature 62. Here's a look at tides. Sunrise at 7:17 a.m., sunset at 5:40 p.m. tomorrow evening. Here's the pattern we've been in. We've been in throughout the fall. Now we're coming into winter, and we're still in this pattern where we've got a pretty active jet stream and basically a big trough in the midsection of the country. And every time a little storm system forms, it is carried eastward and brings us a shot at rain, thunderstorms, and potential flooding. And this pattern is not changing much. So looks like our weather, rather wet weather, will continue. Here's the water vapor loop. Red indicates dry air in the atmosphere. Green indicates moisture, mainly mid and upper level moisture. You can see that stream right here bringing us the high clouds through the day today. Here's the storm system. This system coming out brought the snow to New Mexico. It's lifting to the northeast. Will just skim by us, but come close enough to bring us that pretty good chance for rain tomorrow. And then here's the next system. This is the system that produced the tornado near Huntington Beach, California. It's moving eastward. It's going to get a hold of some of this moisture also and bring us a good chance for showers and thunderstorms on Wednesday. Surface map showing deep low pressure in the midsection of the country. Whole system is moving northeast. The next system already on its heels. Fairly active and unsettled pattern. Lows across the nation tonight, mild in the southeast, cold throughout much of the rest of the country. Highs tomorrow, pretty nice in the south and the southeast, cold just about everywhere else. Our five-day forecast is calling for mild stuff, lots of mild stuff. Rather humid, too. 40% chance for showers tomorrow. Mostly cloudy skies, a high near 78. Partly to mostly cloudy Tuesday, a high near 80. And then for Wednesday, a 60% chance for showers and thunderstorms. Some of that shower activity could linger into Christmas Day. And then we'll see a little bit cooler weather, highs in the low 70s on Christmas Day, but no lows in the mid-60s. And with all this humidity, Santa needs to do some WD-40ing of his sleigh because rust potential is pretty high.
Okay, thanks for that.
Sure.
Well, it's better to give than to receive, and no one knows that better than one man in South Carolina. This came out in West Columbia. More than 1,800 people are on a shopping spree thanks to this good Samaritan, John Fling. Fling sprang for this spree. Each person got to spend $50 a piece. Price tag for all of this, just a mere $88,000 and some change. I guess you call that a fling thing.
I guess.
And that's the end of it for us. That's all the time we have. Thanks for joining us tonight. Stay tuned, though. John's up next with Sunday Sports Extra.
Well, if I had told you back in August that the Bucs would win 10 games this season and that the Dallas Cowboys would lose 10 games this season, you would have walked right up to your television and slapped the screen. That's why I didn't say it. But my, how things turn out. The Buccaneers celebrate one of their best days ever. We'll have the whole story next on Sunday Sports Extra.
MSNBC now on NewsChannel 8's homepage, WFLA.com.
Some days are made to last forever. Beautiful from Estee Lauder. Now red for the holidays. A bright red tote in brilliant lip color. $15 with any Estee Lauder fragrance purchase. This holiday offer is now at Burdine's.
I love being a mom, but I was still miserable because I was so heavy. And I knew I had to do something. I lost over 50 pounds on the SlimFast plan. Just keep them in the fridge, grab them, shake them up, have my lunch while I'm feeding him. It's just such a healthy drink.
Now with 23 vitamins and minerals, protein, calcium, fiber, all the balanced nutrition like a healthy meal.
Oh, I feel very healthy. And I have to be to keep up with him.
SlimFast, balanced nutrition for a healthy life.
What more could you want?
Have a great New Year's Eve.
Bring your family to Busch Gardens.
And celebrate alcohol-free.
Celebrate safe.
Entertainment will include rides, shows, dancing, and some of the animal exhibits.
And by pledging to celebrate safe, you can win airline travel and $1,000.
Get tickets through Ticketmaster and at AAA or Suncoast Schools Federal Credit Union offices.
Support the Hillsborough Education Foundation.
Celebrate safe.
At Busch Gardens.
Happy New Year.
From 8 on your side,
This is Sunday Sports Extra with John McQuiston.
Well, this is the greatest day of my professional career.
6-10 to 10-6, home playoff game. It's just great.
Indeed, for the first time in 15 years, the end of the season isn't the end of the season. And for the first time since 1979, the scoreboard flashed a message saying, playoff tickets go on sale Monday at 10 a.m. The Bucs have a home playoff game next Sunday against the Detroit Lions. That after the Bucs' demolition of the Chicago Bears today. First quarter, Trent Dilfer scrambled around. He finds John Davis for 16 yards, and that sets up, well, this play coming up. Trent again will be scrambling around. This time he does not find anybody, but you know what? He can still run. Bad ankle and all. Here he comes into the end zone. 7 yards, touchdown, 7-0. And this is a big one for him. You can tell by the emphatic spike there. All right, Bears with the ball. Eric Kramer, meet Warren Sapp. Hi, nice to meet you. Yes, indeed. The next play after the Bears forced a punt, Carl Williams. You don't run backwards after you take, you're gonna lose yardage, Carl. You don't run, I can't believe, okay, he makes a couple moves, it looks all right. All right, if you insist, just, Carl, keep running. Just keep running. That's right. You can talk to him later, but right now, he's gone. 61 yards, touchdown, 14-0, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Joe Marciano, the special teams coach, more than mildly excited. Second quarter, 14-7 now. Eric Kramer, though, intercepted by Donnie Abraham of the Buccaneers. That sets up this. Trent, watch his pass coming right at you to Carl Williams. Touchdown, 21-7. The Buccaneers have the lead at halftime. Go to the second half. Eric Kramer. Does this look familiar? Meet Reagan Upshaw. The Bucs' 43rd sack, setting a team record for a season. They finished the game with 44. Now Warwick Dunn, the isolation shot. Darts, dashing, getting out of trouble, getting into trouble, getting out of trouble. And then watch. There he goes. And then the cut. Two camera guys, News Channel 8 doing the job. Bob Hanson, Chris Kerwin, and so is Warwick Dunn. 76 yards, a Buccaneers team record for longest run. Sets up a field goal, 24-7. The Bucs have the lead. Then some trickery, the fake to Mike Allstott, then the handoff to Riddell Anthony. It works here, maybe to work in the playoffs, or at least make the other teams not gang up on Allstott when they line up in that formation. 23 yards, and that leads to this. Eric Rett, still on the team, 5 yards, touchdown. 31-7 there, 31-15. The final.
Sacks on the season.
Rick Meyer? Oh, I forgot about that. We're going to see Warren Sapp. Anyway, here it is again. The Bucs host their first-round playoff game next Sunday at 4 o'clock against the Detroit Lions. Now, while the Bucs have a place in the playoffs, they still don't have respect from everyone in the league.
I guess it does say a lot about our season. You know, we got crushed by, you know, Tampa.
You say got crushed by Tampa. Do you think this is a good playoff team, the Bucs? Do you see them doing anything in the playoffs?
No, I don't.
Then again, Eric Kramer is the quarterback of a team that went 4-12 this season. You can understand if he doesn't recognize what a playoff team looks like. Not so with Dick Crippen. Like the Monkees, he's a believer.
Third down and 6. Here's the snap. Dilfer. Flushed out of the pocket. Dilfer, a flush by Spellman. He throws the ball downfield. Caught!
The Tampa Bay Buccaneers have accomplished what they set out to do. They have the revenge factor against the Chicago Bears, but more importantly, this stadium is going to be used at least one more time in a playoff game next week.
We needed to get out there and play well, and we did today. We made plays, and that's what builds momentum. When you're making big plays, running the ball well, stopping a run, doing whatever it takes to win, you can carry that on with you into the next week.
I think it was us up front. I mean, we made a concerted effort to look each other in the eye and say, we got to stop this running game to get ourselves a shot at going after this pass. And once we got the running game where they weren't popping them for 4 and 5 yards, and it was like 2 yards, 1 yard, then we knew we was going to have a chance to rush them, and that's what we do best.
So we were determined to come out and play. Carl got us going with a couple of returns. Defense, I thought, played well. But you could see we had a little more spark, a little more desire, and, the home fans helped that as well.
It just shows you how much heart's on this team and how much we want to work hard and get better and give back to the community is the most important thing. They've been waiting a long time, and they deserve it.
It's a happy sight, wonderful sight for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Playoff bound, and they have home field advantage for the first game. I'm Dick Crippen, News Channel 8 Sports.
Now, if you want to follow pewter power to the playoffs, you're at the right place. Besides the coverage we'll have all week on the Bucs' preparations for the playoffs, we're going to have a 30-minute show called Pewter power to the playoffs Saturday night at 7:30 right here on News Channel 8. Believe it or not, the Bucs aren't the only team in the NFL playoffs. We'll run down who else still has hopes of going to the Super Bowl and how they kept those hopes alive. That's next in the Extra.
Trucks, cars, imports, you name it. The Deluxe Lube and Oil Service from Walmart's Tire and Lube Express with Pins or Hard Quaker State at a great low price every day. We have Goodyears, VF Goodrich, we even have Michelin's, all at everyday low prices. It's all here at Walmart, plus a few things you won't find anywhere else.
I did my shopping, I was ready to go, and so was my car.
Hey, bring whatever you drive to Walmart's Tire and Lube Express. We'll take care of your car while you take care of the rest.
Why the long face, chum?
It's my car.
Let me show you how things could have been.
Chrysler in Plymouth presents It's a Wonderful Event. Now get $1,500 cash back on Plymouth Neon. Get Chrysler Cirrus LXi at $18,995. Or get up to $1,000 cash back on Plymouth minivans.
Say, are you an angel?
You watch too many movies, friend.
What's so hot about new Hot Pockets?
Crispy, crusty, tender, flaky crust.
Crispy, crusty, tender, flaky crust.
What's so hot about new Hot Pockets?
Crispy, crusty, tender, flaky crust.
Hot Pockets' new crust is so crispy, so flaky, so tender. It tastes so oven-baked, you won't believe it came from a microwave. So your favorite Hot Pockets fillings taste even better. What's so hot about new Hot Pockets?
Crispy, crusty,
tender, flaky crust.
What are you gonna pick? Hot Pockets!
Lean Pockets has a new crispy, crusty, tender, flaky crust, too.
Just undescribable around here right now. You know, the fans are going crazy, and that's how it should be. You know, every, you know, at the end of the year, you know, knowing that you're going to be in the postseason, and man, it's just an awesome feeling.
Players like George Diaz, plainly excited about going to the playoffs, which for all intents started today in the Lions game against the Jets. The winner gets in, the loser goes home. Isn't that what a playoff game is? The Jets get the jump in this one. Adrian Morrell, 14 yards around the left side, touchdown, 10-0. New York has the lead. Barry Sanders needed 137 yards in the game to reach 2,000 for the season. Only 20 yards in the first half. Gets 47 here as the Lions will eventually go in for a touchdown here in the third quarter. An awful moment in the fourth quarter. Lions linebacker Reggie Brown, number 59 there on the left of your screen, jams his neck as he tries to make a tackle and goes down unconscious. The Lions know that this is immediately a serious injury and even help rescue workers bring the gurney onto the field. Brown has to be resuscitated on the field. Jets players gather in a circle to pray. Perhaps the prayers are answered. Brown regains consciousness at the hospital and has movement in his arms and legs, but you can see how that affects players in both teams. It's just terrible. So it looks like it maybe not too terrible. After the game resumes, the Jets try the halfback option. Leon Johnson from the Lions 9 throws the interception. At least that's what the ref said. The replay clearly shows that Brian Westbrook is lying flat on his back out of bounds before he gets control of the ball. Barry Sanders just reached the 2,000-yard mark with a 2-yard run. Next play, there he goes. 53 yards before he will be finally brought down. Seals the victory for the Lions and gives Sanders 2,053 yards for the season. Only Eric Dickerson has run for more in 1 year. Nobody runs like Barry Sanders. All right, the Vikings playing the Colts as they try to come out of the full gagging choke of their 5-game losing streak. Randall Cunningham in for the injured Brad Johnson to Chris Carter. 16 yards, touchdown after the scramble. Nifty catch to keep his feet in bounds. Touchdown, Vikings. The game is tied at 7. Cunningham again to throw. Zings one to Andrew Glover. 29-10 Minnesota. The Vikings win 39-28 to qualify for the playoffs. So the first round of the playoffs looks like this. Saturday, the Vikings play at New York against the Giants. And Sunday, the Bucs host the Detroit Lions, who beat the Bucs here earlier in the season, but that was during the regular season, which is an entirely different animal entirely. In the AFC playoffs, Denver hosts Jacksonville Saturday. The Dolphins play the Patriots tomorrow. The winner hosts the rematch of that same game between the same two teams next Sunday in the playoffs. Next in the Extra, more football! It's been a while, but the Bucs have made the playoffs before, believe it or not. Next, we'll hear from Leroy Selman about what it was like for his team to play in the playoffs. But first, the final scores from the final week of the NFL season.